in which it's supposed to it was supposed to end on the 30th of June this year. But as I've said, these initiatives, which consist of support, exemption, and expediting payments, have been extended further, which aims to support the private sector and economic activities most affected by the consequence of this pandemic. I mean, yeah, I can't stress more to show our gratitude, the gratitude to our government about, you need to show, you need, the amount of care from the government of Saudi Arabia has been giving, and they have been giving, and it costs to allocate these billions of dollars to, you need to support the private sector, has been and still is a great support to all the private sector. So I just wanted to start by saying that we are advising everyone, and can't stress more that we need to follow the instructions of the Ministry of Health to get out of this crisis with minimal material and human, of course, losses. So first, I'm going to present the and explain the work of my department and our role as accounts manager beside hosting these workshops. Then we will share with you the areas in which these initiatives covered. And of course, with me, Mr. Maad will follow up with a detailed explanation about each initiative. Finally, we will cover cases that we have been discussing when we were preparing for this workshop, as it should cover some areas that would concern you. Lastly, as you used to our workshops and in the previous workshops, we always have time to answer your questions. So by the end of this workshop, you'll be able to ask your questions, and we will answer them. We will start by talking about explaining our department's role as accounts manager. Are part of the large taxpayers administration department, and we are Gazette's basically Gazette's representatives to all large taxpayers. Gazette assigned a team of high experienced people to face the day-to-day issues of large taxpayers, and to support them in every possible way. When it comes to all Gazette's services, I mean answering their questions, giving them tax advices, and even linking large taxpayers to all Gazette's departments and following with all their requests. Basically, Gazette made this effort to ensure the relationship between Gazette and large taxpayer to show our care and how much we value this relationship. Therefore, your assigned account manager will cover all of your queries with all of Gazette's departments, whether it is as it shows here, an audit matter, collection matter, finance, with finance, or even with risk, legal requests, appeals, or registration process. I mean, all foreign investors, when they register in Gazette, we assign a specialized account manager to help them with Gazette's requests, and of course technical support. And account manager will always try to to tackle any issue or compliance matter before it actually occurs by reminding. I'm sure everyone got emails from their accounts manager reminding them about their payment due date and filing deadlines, and of course last but not least, your account manager will notify you about any regulations, adjustments, and even send invitations to events, and even share news, or even will always even contact your company's team to ensure them to always also attend these events that we host on a regular basis. So so this is basically in a summary our work. If you have any questions, anything related to Gazet, if you need any advice regarding your company's please don't hesitate to contact your account manager. I'm sure he will be a great help to you and your company. So so as you can see in the screen, we used almost the same slide we in previous workshops. Mr. Muad has prepared a summary of these initiatives. We changed, of course, the dates of the initiatives, the deadline in which it will be the end of this month. So basically, the deferral will be deferral on customs paid importing paid at customs. It will be deferred, and it will be paid in your tax return as it's for VAT and of course excise tax, and also suspension penalties will be on installments, late payments, amendment of declaration. Any amendment of past declarations will be there will be no penalties, as we have explained this before many times, that you have the chance to go back to all tax returns and adjust them and amend them without getting any penalties. Of course, these tax returns should be, their dues should be before the 18th of March. Any tax returns due before the 18th of March, you will be able to amend without getting any penalty. So and of course, non-cooperative and audit penalties will not be applicable in this in these initiative periods. And Gazet also, as we have said before, and we have been working, day and night on accepting all. Of course, if it follows the policy, the installment plans without insisting on paying the down payment, and of course we are working always on accelerating payments towards all of your refunds requests. So we have been working to ensure that we accept and we support all of support you in every possible way. Of course, end of this month will be the end of our initiative the procedure related to suspension of government services, as the end of this month is the end of this initiative. Starting September going back to suspension of government services for all uncomplied taxpayers. Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to explain these wonderful initiatives to the private sector. Mr. Muad will further explain, and he will be taking over.
Thanks, Nahda. Thanks for this brief summary about the initiative. Now we will go through the exemptions from penalties for registered taxpayers. And after that, we will talk about exemptions from penalties for unregistered taxpayers. Starting with registered taxpayers, we will be able to clean or delete all penalties of taxpayers for all kinds of tax, including Zakat. The exemptions is only for the amount or the period between 13 March until the end of September 2020. Any amendment on previous submitted tax returns will be included in this initiative, and any outstanding declarations are also included in this initiative. So the conditions of that is three main conditions. The first of them, tax returns due date should be before 18th of March 2020. So all due dates should be before 18th of March, so August, July, June declarations are not included in this initiative. But the second thing, the submitting and the amendment should be between the period of 18th of March until the end of September 2020. After that, taxpayers should finalize all of their payments, and if they have any struggling in their financials, then they can use an installment plan. Moving on to the unregistered taxpayers, all penalties for unregistered taxpayers are included also in this initiative. So it's an exceptional opportunity for those taxpayers to fix all of their all of their financials and all of their previous error in their returns. So the unregistered taxpayers should register. Secondly, they have to submit all of their due returns and then finalizing their returns by doing the payment or having an installment plan instead. The installment plan and the taxpayer cannot clarify their declarations. If they have any obstacles, financial or financial obstacles, then they can do an installment plan. The installment plan actually requests all amounts due from taxpayers without requiring any limits or restrictions as before. Also, the 20% down payment is excluded from this request. So you can request installment plan without any down payments, without any limits, without any restrictions, just doing all the conditions of their applications by doing their installment application on the online portal, or they can use the installment plan email and sending all their requirements there if it is not possible to do it in the portal. Also, you can call your account manager anytime and send them an email to communicate regarding this installment plan. So installment plan and refund people, refund companies without audit or making the audit later on, those are some facilities to make their life easier. So the penalties exempted from this initiative are batch penalties as shown in the screen, the 10,000 for registration, 50% for any differences or any differences in your declaration, and the 5% to 25% for late penalties, late filing penalties, and finally the 5% penalty each month or each month due dated. Also, the excise tax penalties from 5% to 25% are excluded. The 5% of unpaid due dated returns are also excluded. Also, the CIT, the income tax and withholding tax, late penalties and late filing are also included in this MST. So here we will start talking about some practical examples of exemptions. We have two main examples, how this initiative works, and how are the calculation of those amounts, and how much the calculation before and after the amnesty.
Yeah, so as we have said that we have prepared some test cases. I would like to just mention one thing. I feel like some people got mixed up by that we have extended the initiatives, but we a part of these initiatives, the old initiatives, but we haven't the submission and payment of VAT monthly return and other kinds of tax returns hasn't been extended. The last VAT extended tax return was May's tax return. Am I right, Mr. Maal? I feel like people got mixed up by other that we have been even extending other tax returns. The submission of tax returns will be the same as of June, will be the 31st of July, July 31st of August will be 30th of September, and so on. September will be 31st of October. That hasn't changed. But the other initiatives, which includes, as you have said, the deferral for the customs paid at customs, and the deferral for the amendment, and what we have explained. So so the first practice case is a taxpayer has reviewed the data of the external activities and noted some paid services to the head office that haven't been declared for 10 million Saudi riyal, which occurred in January 2016. What is the correct procedure in this case, Mr. Mann?
Yeah.
Can you hear me, Mr. Maal?
Yes. So now, regarding this 10 million, the 15% withholding tax is objected to this 10 million regarding those services. This service is 15%, not 5%, because it's regarding the head office. So 1,500,000 is included. The penalties of late payments is 840,000. So the total amount should be paid in the regular way should be 2,340,000 Saudi riyal after the initiative or during this initiative period, if the taxpayer have clarify all their payments, it should be only 1,500,000.
Yeah. Yeah, that's clear. So what about the taxpayer hasn't declared a contract advance payment on February 2018, which equals 12 million. Later on, the return has been audited and reassessed.
Okay, in this case, it is audited. So the audit cases are included in the initiative. So that 600,000 riyal, which is 5% of the 20 million, should be included as a VAT payment or a VAT obligation. Then the error of penalties, which is 50%, 300,000. The late payment penalties from the beginning of the of February, from the end of February 2018, each month has 5%. So it's 900,000 Saudi riyal. The total amount is 1,800,000 riyal.
And that's after a huge.
During this initiative, it's only you have to pay only that amount, which is 600,000 riyal. And this is applied to all kind of taxes and all kind of those houses. So those are two examples that's included in all kind of taxes.
Yeah, that shows great support to the private sector. I mean, the difference is huge, given the usual circumstances, as you have said, would be 1,800,000. Okay, so we will be asking you some questions.
So here we have some questions. Frequent questions have been gathered from your registration application. So Banda will ask those questions.
Yeah, during the process, these questions have been collected. So the first question mentioned that the amounts were disclosed, but penalties were issued. What is the mechanism for cancelling penalties?
Okay, regarding the penalties, when the taxpayer have submitted or changed their declarations, the penalties are automatically generated from the system. So they have to wait few days until those penalties are removed from the gazette's employee. So when it's if it is not removed or has any issues in 4 or 5 days, then the taxpayer can call or communicate their account manager. Their account manager will support and fix this issue directly.
Yeah, surely. We have faced many issues, and it has been corrected and fixed immediately. So, in which cases penalties cannot be exempt?
The all penalties are actually exempted, but the penalties or the amounts that have objections in the current time or previously are not included. Initiative. Also, the amount or the due date of the declarations of January, of March, January, March, April, May, June, July, August are also not included in this initiative. Any due dates after 18th of March are not included in this initiative, so penalties cannot be exempt.
Okay, that's clear. Hold on just a second. Okay, so here it says a taxpayer has in process appeal with the GSTC and would like to get advantage of the initiatives and pay the objected amount without penalties. Is it possible?
Actually, in this case, any appeals in process on GSTC or in objects legal side here in the Gazette are not included, unfortunately.
Okay. Can you please repeat your answer, Mr. Maran?
Any kind of declarations or any kind of in the objection or in the legal side here in Gazette are not included or cannot be exempted in this initiative.
Yeah.
So the if the audit case, if they have audit case, in this case, yes, they can be benefited from this.
Okay, just a second, Mr. Maad.
Excuse me?
Just a second, we will have, we are keeping a technical settings here in the world. Okay, moving on. I apologize. So we usually pay via international transfer. Do you consider the transfer date or the date of receiving the payment?
Actually, an international transfer payment, the transfer payment should be before the end of September. And the taxpayer should guarantee that the payment was received in Gazette before 13th of September. So they have to communicate with their outside banks and internal banks to make sure that the payment will be received here in Saudi Arabia and Gazette account before the due date. And this is actually applicable in all kind of communication with Gazette. Any kind of transaction should be in the same.
Yeah, so we are not responsible for any delay maybe caused by external banks. They should, the taxpayers should, be aware that they should be ready for these kind of things and make the transfers earlier. So I will repeat the GSTC amount as some audience have been requesting to repeat it. A taxpayer has in process appeal and with GSTC and would like to get advantage of the initiatives and pay the objected amount without penalties. Is it possible?
As I said, the GSTC, and process appeal or objection appeal are not included in this issue.
Okay, clear. So, can the declaration applied on a closed VAT audit case, and can we get advantage of the initiatives if there are issued penalties?
As we said, regarding audit cases, also audit cases are included in this initiative. The taxpayer should declare about any amounts or errors in their declarations. They have that audit, so they have to communicate with their account manager or to let the auditor know that the amount is declared from the taxpayer. So that audit cases are included in this initiative. They have the advantage to remove all penalties of audit if they apply or they apply for their request.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes.
So, Mr. Baad, now we're going to be moving on to answering some of the questions in the Q&A bar. As I advise you to, if we haven't answered your questions or you still have questions related to this matter or any other matters in Gazette, please don't hesitate to email these email addresses here shown in the screen, foreign@gazette.gov.sa and ltpcare@gazette.gov.sa. If you don't know your accounts manager, please contact these emails. We will be happy to assist you and help you and direct you always. So So we will start picking out some questions. Here's Mr. Yusuf is asking if he gets an assessment during the initiatives period and got penalties with this assessment. Is it possible to cancel them? Can you hear me, Mr. Mayad?
Yes. Yes, me.
Yeah, is the question clear? Do you want me to repeat it?
Yes,
please. Mr. Mayad?
Yes, yes. Can you repeat the question, please?
Yeah, Mr. Yusuf is asking, he got an assessment during the initiative period, and he was wondering if the penalties he got with the assessment are possible to be cancelled or not.
Yeah, if the due date of this amount are before 18th of March, and this audit reassessment have been issued between 18th of March until 13th of September, in this scenario or in this case, the taxpayer can finalize their payment after finalizing all the payments for the base amount, then the penalties will be removed automatically.
That's clear. Okay, so here's Mr. Hussein asking, I have contacted our account manager asking about the due date for July 2020 VAT payment. He said the last day was today, August 31st. So yeah, your account manager is correct. As we have mentioned, right, Mr. Mayad, that you haven't extended any payment or funding dates further to May tax return in the VAT. Yeah, so okay, Mr. Rushdie is saying we need a workshop on withholding tax. Actually, we have been discussing this with the team. We will be working on a workshop for withholding tax. Of course, it will be very beneficial. If you have any concerns or any questions regarding withholding tax that we could include in the workshop, please don't hesitate to send your requirements to the email shown here. And if there's any subjects for Engadget needs clarification or you need workshops about, please send an email to these emails shown in the screen. So okay, so here Mr. Ayat is saying, good afternoon, is the VAT on imported goods during the initiatives period exempted or rescheduled in different period? He's asking about the process of declaring the imports.
Regarding the amount of VAT and export, those amounts are not exempted, actually, it's delayed. So taxpayers should have this in their declaration after they earn their future returns.
Okay, so here Mr. Khaja is saying we have paid the VAT on time, but we still got a penalty, I guess. Well, will we get the credit back? If yes, when? So we advise you, Mr. Khaja, to contact your accounts manager and he will solve this problem for you. Otherwise, please contact these emails shown in the screen and we will surely assist you. Okay, so here's Arsalan saying we have closed VAT audit case 2019. There were penalties. And we had paid in 2019. Can we amend the return now and penalties will be returned? He wants to amend an audited tax return. Okay, so we have been, so here the audited if the tax return is prior to the 18th of March, you can amend it, and of course yani there will be no penalties if you amend any tax returns prior to 18th of March 2020. So please go ahead and amend your tax returns if you find out that you have been missing out some information. You can declare it as we have mentioned in the practice cases. It's a huge difference when you when you're benefiting from the penalty from the initiatives in regards to the usual procedure gazette would take if these initiatives end. So thank you so much for attending the workshop today. It was a great pleasure for me and Mr. Mu'adh to present these information, and I hope it has been beneficial to everyone. Please, we apologize if you if we haven't answered all of the questions, but because of the tight timing, as we have other workshops, and please don't hesitate to email the mentioned emails in the screen if you are requesting some more workshops or if you are advising us add some information or talk about some areas, cover some areas more. Thank you so much, Mr. Mu'adh. It has been a great pleasure as always. Thank you everyone for attending today. Take care, stay safe, and we will see you next time. Sure, surely. Good night.